777.
All right. Hi everybody. Welcome to the gosh, that echo, bro. The first official episode of the Dynamic Wizard podcast. I have my buddy here, Khye Way Wong, aka Khye the Guy, aka okay. Kyler Diggins, aka DeMar the Asian, aka Assistant Coach Khye. Hi, Coach Khye. How are you, bro?
I'm good. Well, hello everybody watching the podcast.
You guys, nobody's watching right now, bro. Let's be honest. We have no viewers yet.
You have like 30 views in 4 days.
Yeah, bro. So,
I mean, you guys heard all my nicknames. Yes, I don't have one for Matt yet. I'll keep figuring it out. But hello.
I feel like nobody's been able to come up with a good nickname for me, bro. I don't know what it is. I'm always coming up with nicknames for like everybody else, but like nobody comes up with one for me.
I know, but where does the nickname Kyler Diggins come from? Because
Skylar Diggins, bro, the WNBA player.
Oh my God.
You're just like her, bro. Your games are very similar.
Oh, she's taller than me. I can probably shoot better, so.
True. So anyways, we were supposed to do this like several weeks ago, but adult conflicting schedules. Yeah, but luckily we're doing it today. I had a whole intro planned, bro. But we're a little short on time because technology is ass, bro. And we had to figure out this whole situation. And it's still not even perfect, bro. There's this echo going on when I talk, and it's terrible.
Do you still hear it? It's kind of annoying, too.
Yeah. I'm thinking about taking my headphones off, to be honest. I'm going to go like this. You can do it, too, unless you're okay. I had this whole introduction planned for you, bro. And we just can't do it anymore. You know, it was like about how much I appreciate Asian culture. For the people watching, if you can't tell, you are Asian, right? That's okay to say.
Yeah.
That's okay to
I mean, they can go ahead and guess which country I'm from, but yeah.
Definitely. We don't want to stereotype. I don't know if guessing is probably like the best thing to do.
I'm not Japanese.
And that was surprising to me.
I'm not Korean.
I could tell that. Koreans are probably respectfully my favorite kind of Asian, to be honest with you.
I'm not Vietnamese.
Not Vietnamese. The Vietnamese are kind of wild. So tell the people what you are. What are you?
I am Malaysian.
And I don't think I've ever, before you, I don't think I had ever met a Malaysian person.
Well, there's only like 35 million of us. So if you get to meet one,
yeah,
I heard that you're actually super lucky.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So we're all lucky. So you're here today. So thank you, Khye, for being here today. We also have your lovely better half here, Emma, in the background. Hi, Emma.
She is right there.
Yeah, she is. She came with you. Like I said, we were supposed to do this several weeks ago, but we just never got around to it. But we're here today. It's finally happening. So how have you been, bro?
It's been good. It's been stressful. We've been trying to look for apartments, and the rent now is crazy.
It is crazy, bro. So, bro, you're here obviously because you're like in school. So, how many years have you been here?
This is gonna be my fourth year here in the country.
Fourth year. Okay.
I landed actually the last day of December in 2019.
Yeah, yeah.
So it was a whole big change, you know. First of all, the culture.
Yeah.
The people. Yeah.
Turn this a little bit so that it's facing you. Yeah.
Being away from family too. I mean, I have my family here and, you know, 45 minutes away.
Yeah. But so you do have family here. And they were here before you got here, obviously, right? So yeah, that's how you kind of, because we live in kind of like a random area, like South Texas. It's small. Like, I wouldn't expect anybody from like an Asian country to know, or, you know, although we do have a pretty good Asian population here.
I think it's growing too.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'm going to be honest, bro. I feel like you're from a part of the world where like, it's relatively developed, right? You're from Asia. Asians are smart. The economy is relatively strong in most parts of Asia, right? I feel like when most people decide to migrate or like come to school in the United States, they're from like a third world kind of place where there's not a lot of opportunity. But in Malaysia, is there like a perception? Did you have this perception of the United States where it was like, you know, I have to go to the USA to like get a better education and be like successful and whatnot?
Well, for most of us that want to further our study overseas,
yeah,
we just look at maybe Australia,
uh-huh,
England, and the United States of America, because
really,
yeah, it's always been a dream of mine to come.
Yeah,
we do have the perception like if you graduate here and you go back, you're gonna get a better job.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's what it is. That is actually true. Yeah.
Because I feel like Malaysia or Asia in general probably has like solid education. You know, there's a lot of you know, some of the like billionaires, if you look at billionaires in the world, a lot of them are probably Asian, you know, and they're CEOs of huge corporations. Obviously, you know, a lot of corporations are like based in Asia, like China, Japan, places like that. So, you know, I feel like, because, you know, obviously people who are like from Mexico or like South America and places like that, they see America and they see opportunity, obviously, because they live in a trash can, you know. But I feel like Asia's like fairly strong, like, you know, in relation to, like, relative to the USA, like, it's comparable, I feel like, you know?
I don't know if I'm Mexican or not, but I see the same thing they see when I see in America.
Really?
Yeah, when I see America, I see opportunities, because where else are you going to get such great opportunities here, especially when, you know, I want to pursue my career in the sports field.
Yeah.
You know, America is definitely the way to go, because everything is so developed here.
Okay, yeah.
From high school sports to college to professional, you know,
yeah,
they make everything so grand and
right.
It's just okay. So many opportunities here.
So that's obviously true. Like from your perspective, you're pursuing a career like in kind of like professional sports. And obviously in America, the United States, you know, we like our sports are like high level, and obviously the best players are usually from the United States in multiple like sports. So let's talk about that a little bit. So, this past year, right, we had the opportunity. I coach basketball at a school here, a small school. And, this year you came on and you kind of were like assistant coach for basketball. And you're kind of like pursuing a career in that sort of field, right? Whether you're playing or you're coaching or something like that. And, you're studying what at college right now? Or university?
I'm actually just going for the basic kinesiology degree. Mm-hmm. I'm almost done. I'm in my senior year. I graduate in December.
Yeah.
So that's pretty exciting to me.
Yeah. And so you obviously grew up playing like sports, right? Mostly what, basketball?
Mostly basketball. I played, I don't know, it's not a very popular sport here, but badminton.
Okay.
I played a lot of badminton growing up. That's an Asian sport.
Yeah.
But ever since I was 9-10 years old, it's been basketball since. Yeah.
So you and I, we coached together at this school. We had a pretty good season. We went 15-4. We won a national tournament. So it was good. You know, we got to work with the kids. So was that your first time like coaching?
That's actually my first time coaching organized basketball.
Yeah.
Where, you know, we started as a team, you know, from one season until the end. So yeah, that was my first time doing something like that.
And did that like experience, did it like further like cement or like further your interest in like actually pursuing?
Yeah, definitely did. Because when I first started out in school, my first or second year, I'm still deciding whether or not to go the athletic training route, right? The strength and conditioning or basketball. But ever since I started watching more basketball and, you know, coaching that with you, it just definitely cemented my thought of, okay, I want to be a basketball coach. This is what I want to do for the rest of my life.
Yeah, that's good, bro. And so now you're doing something different, right? Now you're doing something different. You have a good opportunity right now.
Yeah, right now.
So tell the people what it is that you're doing. You have an internship right now.
Right now I do have an internship, but it's not with a basketball team. It is with a professional soccer team.
Yeah.
They play in the second division in the USL. So That is really cool.
Being
around professional players.
Yeah. So it's a soccer team. I mean, we can say where it is. Like, I'm not somebody who's like private and I don't want anybody to know like the area where I live in. So we live in South Texas, right? The Rio Grande Valley. So it's a team that it's not MLS, right? Like you said. So they're the RGV Toros, right? That's a team that we have down here. And so you're an intern for them. So what do you like do? What do you usually do? Like what's a day at the job for you?
A day at the job. I would go in typically 2 hours before the practice.
Yeah.
I would have to get their practice gear, everything sorted out in their locker room.
Yeah.
And then I have to get the training plan from the coaches. Okay. I would make a copy of it. Mm-hmm. And me and this other, I could call him my coworker. He's this equipment manager, team admin. We we'll head out to the field an hour before the practice actually starts to set up the practice fields, make sure everything is set up, every equipment is there that they need. And once practice starts, we basically just stay there and we watch them practice and everything. And you know, you're just a part of the team. Wherever they go, we go. I go.
So rub them down with baby oil, get them boys nice and slick, nice and ready to go. Massage those calves.
We're not there yet.
Those glutes, baby. Got to get those glutes loose to run around.
We're not there yet, but...
you will be.
Hopefully.
Oh, yeah. So do you feel like, you know, now... So you went from like a just like a high school. So now you're working with like professionals. Do you feel like a greater sense of responsibility? Like you have to do your job well because their performance kind of depends on your job, right? Like if you don't do your job well enough, like it kind of can affect their performance.
Yeah. I don't want to say there's a lot of pressure on it because everyone there works like family.
Yeah.
Even from, you know, from the top to the bottom, everyone helps out each other.
Yeah.
Whether or not you're, whether you're responsible for content creating, if you're the head coach, if you're the assistant coach, everyone just works together. So everyone communicates really well. There's not much pressure to it, but obviously I still want to do the best that I can because I'm an intern.
Yeah,
I want to get their stuff ready, everything set, you know, having the practice fields ready. That way they can just go and, you know, do their best that they can.
Yeah. A lot of moving parts. Yeah, that's cool, bro. That's fire. I think that's a good opportunity. And as far as like what you're studying and what you want to do with your career, like I think it's like a great opportunity, you know. Yeah, just out there with all them soccer players, all them thighs, baby, all them
thick thighs.
Thick thighs, thick boy. Yes, sir. Yeah, you have a great pair of thighs yourself, if I do say so myself.
Oh, thank you. I haven't been working them as much, you know.
It's time. But maybe that's being an adult.
How about you? What you know, you released the first episode last week.
I did. It was exciting. It was like a mini, just like an introduction. But yeah, this is kind of like always something I wanted to do. I just thought it'd be fun. You know, I'm not super social and I don't like small talk. Like you'll be in the line at the local Walmart, you know, and you have a few avocados and the guy behind you wants to say like, oh, what are you going to make some, go home and make some guacamole. And now you're like in this like small talk conversation. It's kind of annoying, you know? But yeah, I still like to, you know, have conversations like meaningful, like, you know, so I thought this would be kind of fun to do that. You know,
what has been going on for the past week? Is there anything new? Is there anything interesting?
I've just been kind of chilling, you know, helping out. That junior high is in basketball season. So I've been kind of helping out with that, getting ready to start my nursing school. So I'm kind of getting, I start next month. So yeah, bro, I'm about to be in the trenches with that. So yeah, I'm just taking advantage of my free time right now, I guess. Yeah, today I went to the gym, bro, and we go to the same gym.
We go to the same,
and it's a fine gym, you know, for the most part. It's nothing fancy. It has everything you need. It has some machines, some dumbbells, cardio equipment, and for the most part, it's fine, bro, but, you know, it has its quirks. You know, the people who go there are not douchey or anything like that, but... first of all, bro, let me tell you, it was a whole thing. I show up and I realize I don't have my headphones, bro. So I'm almost like, you know what? I'm not even going to get out of my car. I'm just going to go straight home because, you know, the gym playlists are notoriously
They're kind
of
trash.
Bad. Yeah, yeah.
They are.
But, you know, I figured it's almost summer. I'm trying to fit in this thong bikini. I got one ordered on Amazon. It's about to show up. So I was like, you know what? Let me get in here and get this workout in. Bro, I walk in there. The AC is broken.
That's what I was going to tell you. I was going to ask you, do you feel like the AC is broken?
Bro, it's broken all the time. And I feel like they were on a streak of like a several months where it was fine. You know, but I walk in there today and we live in South Texas. It's almost summer. It's humid. You expect to go inside and like feel the relief of AC.
Yeah.
I walk in there, bro. It smells like straight ball, sweaty ball sacks. We're eating garlic bread or something, bro. It's so bad. And yeah, it's just, I'm sensitive to the heat, bro. Once it's like 75, I can't deal. You know, I spend all summer contemplating whether it's worth going on, you know, whether it's worth living. So yeah, I walk in there. It's just bad, bro. It smells like sweaty ball sacks. It's just humid. I start sweating immediately, you know, and I walk over to the dumbbells, which is its own like little room kind of, and it's even hotter, bro. It's even hotter. And then I forget my headphones and the playlist is going and the music is actually like, okay. That's what I will say. The playlists down there are usually like, okay. But today, I don't know what it was, bro. They played like a Snoop song and then it was like Sicko Mode. And then after that, I'm listening to freaking Garth Brooks, bro. Country music. And I'm like, what the fuck is this? You know? So yeah, bro, it was, you know, usually I like to listen to music and it kind of like motivates me or whatever, but yeah, the music was not it today, and it was hot and I was struggling, and yeah, bro, I don't know.
I was gonna say, like, I was there last week, right, and I felt something was off, because the moment you step foot in the gym,
you just feel it. It's like you get slapped in the face with a fart.
Or like, yeah, exactly, yeah. And it kind of smells bad too.
It smelled terrible.
And I was there yesterday, mm-hmm. and it was the same thing.
Yeah, and then you ask them, it's like, what's going on with the AC? And they're like, oh, it's broken. We're trying to get it fixed. And it's like, what? Well, but it's every day. Weeks. Yeah, yeah.
You know, so, let's talk about the season that we had, shall we?
Our basketball season.
Yeah,
yeah, bro, it was good. I mean, you know, we had a couple kids who, we had one kid who, you know, he was ranked nationally in steals. He averaged 7 steals per game, 18 points per game. And then we had Cap. We won't say names to protect, obviously, they're minors.
Showtime.
Yeah, Showtime. And then we had Cap, who, you know, averaged like 22. Yeah. Yeah, we had a good season, bro. It was really, really good.
I think it was such a great experience for me, because they actually treat you like buddies off the court. You know,
And well, you're relatively close to their age. You know, you're only maybe like 5 years, 4 or 5 years
old. 4 or 5 years apart, yeah. And everything just went. I mean, we had a rough start. Mm-hmm. You know, I remember our first game, we lost by a point.
Yeah, to a trash team.
To a team that we're not going to say who.
Yeah.
But if we played them again, we'll probably
destroy
them by at least 30 points.
Absolutely.
But that was a tough start. And I knew, you know, a lot of tempers were flaring between teammates.
Yeah.
And that was barely the first game of the season.
Yeah, yeah.
And,
well, Cap, you know, he's a hothead, bro. He's a hothead. Yeah. He wants to win.
Yeah, I know they all do it because they want to win.
Yeah.
They're young kids. Mm-hmm. They want to compete hard. They want to play hard. They want to win. But I just love seeing the growth that they had throughout the season.
Yeah.
Where, you know, we just came together. We gelled so well together as a team.
Yeah.
From the coaches to the players. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what helped us, you know, win games.
Yeah, bro. I mean, it's really like, for me, coaching is like, it's almost like being a chef, you know. I feel like a lot of coaches, they have like their system or whatever, the way that they do things, and they just try to implement it with any team, with any player. And sometimes it doesn't work. It's just like, you know, Phil Jackson with his triangle thing when he went over there to, where did he go? Like New York or something like that. Yeah. And he tried it and it didn't work. It's because like when you show up, bro, your players are like your ingredients, you know? And if you have like spaghetti and marinara and meatballs, you're not going to try to make enchiladas, you know, you're going to try to make spaghetti and meatballs, you know? And that's the same thing with you have to look at like your players' capabilities. What are they each capable of? What do they bring to the table? And you have to build a system around that. You know, so this season, I think we did like a really, really good job at like using the strengths of our team, of our individual players, to like make a system that, you know, obviously worked and was successful. Yeah. But speaking of basketball, bro, NBA playoffs, brother.
The playoffs are here.
Gosh, I just love watching those big black guys run around and dunk the basketball, bro.
I know. And sometimes
sweating,
you don't,
all over each other.
And you don't notice it at
giving
all.
Giving each other staph infection.
And they just, you know, they just come right on your face.
Yes,
because,
bro.
You know,
where they suck in the D. It's beautiful. Yeah. No, but some good games, bro. Some good games. That Warriors series, bro. Oh, my
God. That Warriors series is starting to heat up. The Lakers-Grizzlies series. I thought the Celtics were going to have an easy one with the Hawks because I'm a Celtics fan.
Yeah.
But it doesn't seem like it. Game 6 today, you know?
Bro, I mean, it's just so crazy. Like, you know, you hear it all the time, but sometimes when you're watching teams during the regular season, it's hard to believe. Like, we know the Warriors and Braun and, like, I'm a Heat fan. We're built for the playoffs, bro. Like, we might have a subpar regular season, but when we get in the playoffs, it's like a different story, bro. Yes. Jimmy Buckets, baby. He is.
Because the Heat was actually, I think, to me, they were underperforming in the regular season.
Yeah, yeah.
They were struggling. They were inconsistent for the most part. A lot of injuries too, I believe.
Yeah.
But man, playoff Heat is different.
Bro, we closed out them boys last night. We got them out of there. Freaking Giannis, bro, is looking like a, that dude is looking like a big ass string bean in that Milwaukee Bucks jersey.
He still had a great game. 38 points and 20 rebounds, I believe.
Wasn't enough, baby. Jimmy Buckets. Hey, what did he score the other day? Like 54?
56. And he had 40 something
last night,
yesterday?
I think. Yeah, and that last second to send us to OT, baby.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, but speaking about Giannis, did you see his interview?
Yeah, when the guy asked him if...
I liked his response. Yeah, yeah. It was like...
Those journalists are so stupid, bro. They ask the dumbest, like, most offensive... It's like, are they trying to offend, you know?
And I don't know if they get part of the fine money, because if the players just lash out, they get fined easily, 25,000 to 30,000.
Yeah, it's wild, bro. No, but that was a solid series on our part. And then we're going to face the Knicks, who are also a surprise, bro. Jalen Brunson, he's just a winner. I mean, he comes out of that Villanova system with Coach Jay Wright, bro. And those guys are just winners, bro. Yeah.
That was a surprise to me. I thought that series would have gone to at least 6 or 7. Mm-hmm. But to me, it was in favor of the Cavs.
Yeah.
Because
the
Cavs, to me, are... I think they're deeper.
Yeah.
First of all, they're bigger.
Mm-hmm.
They have... You know, players like Garland, Allen.
Yeah.
They have Donovan Mitchell. Donovan Mitchell has been on a tear.
Yeah, bro.
I thought the Cavs were gonna have it, but the Knicks.
Yeah, no. And so now we're gonna play them, the Miami Heat, and then the Warriors, bro. And this Sacramento, you know, Sac. They haven't been in the playoffs in like 20 years or something like that.
Yep.
And they had a good season, bro. But I feel like they're maybe like, you remember that season the Hawks had like the best record in the NBA?
Yes,
and then they just fell off completely. By
LeBron.
Yeah.
With the Cavs, yeah.
I feel like that's going to be maybe them. I don't know. De'Aaron Fox is really good. But I fell asleep last night. I was watching the game, but I fell asleep before it was over. And I saw the score. I was like, oh, dang, they came back. And
they did. Sabonis has been playing well, too.
And they played in Sac last night, didn't they?
So now
they
got
to go back
home,
to San Fran. It's a wrap, bro. It's a wrap.
Because everyone knows it's hard to win. On the Warriors' ground, so you know,
bro,
it's not easy to win there. It's been like that for the past six, seven years.
Yeah, yeah. You know? And then during the race, I mean, they were trash on the road, but at home, they were like, it was like they were like
they're probably 30, one of the best,
36 and like 3 at home or something like that. Yeah, it was insane. And Steph, bro, in the playoffs, he's just on a different level.
You just never count them up. You know, with Clay and Steph and Draymond, you know, you just never count them out.
What's your finals prediction? Who do you think is going to be?
I'm going to be a little bit biased because I'm a Celtics fan.
Yeah.
I'm going to say Celtics is going to come out the East. They're going to get past the Philadelphia 76ers.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to defeat whoever wins from the Miami and New York series.
Mm-hmm.
In the Western Conference, I do want to see a Celtics... Suns finals, because I think that would be very, very interesting.
Yeah, that'd be entertaining.
Because, you know, with KD there now, it's gonna elevate the series. But I wouldn't complain if it was another Celtics Warriors series to get revenge.
Yeah.
I think that's very likely, but my ultimate prediction, I'm gonna go with Celtics and Suns.
Yeah, yeah. I have to go with the Heat, bro. That's my team. I've been a Heat fan for like over maybe like 13, 14 years now. So I got to go with the Heat. I think we're going to win it every year. Every year I'm like, this is our year, you know? And I think this might be the year that we're going to get back to the finals, I think. And I think it's going to be Warriors, bro. And I called Warriors. I said, the Warriors are going, when they won last year, I was like, they're going back. They got the next three to four. They got the next 3 to 4. And everybody was like, ah, you're crazy. They're not even playing that good, blah, blah, blah. But bro, them playoff Warriors are a different animal, bro.
The playoff, especially when all of them are healthy.
Yeah,
you got to be careful.
Yeah, they just get in there and they just raw dog every team that, they just...
And they just eat you good, you know?
Oh, they eat you up. They eat you up. Yeah. So that's what I think, bro. That's what I think. And then I'm not sure. You know, I'd love to say that we could beat the Warriors, the Miami Heat, but I think it's going to be like a 6 or 7 game series for sure. And then we'll see who wins. We'll see who wins.
It has to go to 6 or 7. The NBA wants money.
Yeah, it has to. It has to. Did you watch that Ryan Garcia versus Tank Davis fight?
I did not, actually.
But you heard about it.
I forgot about it because I believe that night I was cooking something. I don't remember
what
I was
there cooking up, huh?
Yeah, but that fight, the build-up was great.
The build-up was great, yeah, but I just feel like Ryan Garcia, bro, he's like one of these TikTok guys, you know?
Yeah, but...
And Tank Davis is like a real fighter.
Both were undefeated.
Yeah.
Both going in. I believe both had to cut weight, I believe.
Well, Ryan Garcia had to cut more, and then he had a no rehydration clause in his contract where he wasn't allowed to gain more than like 5 or 10 pounds or something like that.
But I think ultimately, when I watched the highlights, you know, Tank was, he is amazing.
Yeah,
you know, the way he boxes. He is just, on another level on that day. And, you know, one liver shot, Ryan Garcia was about to get up.
Put the boy down.
Yep. He just couldn't.
Yeah, he was definitely pissing blood after that, probably. Yeah, it was, I mean, you know, I thought Ryan Garcia was doing, but you could just tell, like, just the way that Tank Davis was, like, managing the fight, managing his distance, his footwork, his head movement. He looked like a real fighter, and Ryan Garcia is just kind of out there, like, trying to use that one shot, that left hook. He wasn't doing the technical things that he needed to do to really, like, you know, get his... But
probably, you know, the build-up, the nerves, you know, that has to come with the mental aspect of sports already.
Yeah,
you
know? For sure. And that's true of any sport, you know. And I do believe, like, you know, on any given night, anybody can beat anybody, regardless of whatever sport it is. But usually it's the more experienced, like the smarter, you know, smarter team, smarter fighter who has the advantage, I feel like, you know. So, yeah. Let's see what else.
What else has been going on? What else has been interesting? it's just me trying to look for apartments.
Trying to look for apartments.
It's been stressful.
Yeah, and we got to kind of wrap up a little bit early because you have an appointment, don't you?
We do. We do.
Yeah, something with a pool so I can go over there with my thong bikini and, you know,
take a dip. I would love to see that.
Yeah, I'm sure, bro. I got this OnlyFans. I might try to get this OnlyFans off the ground. I don't know yet. I don't know if I want to just do...
And it's just going to be you?
Yeah.
I'm not going to take your pictures.
Bro, I need help. Come on. I need help. I need...
My girlfriend can probably help you.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll get take your pictures.
Yeah, we'll get that organized. So let's see. You're a senior, right, in college now? You're done in December?
I should be.
Yeah.
Yes, I should
be done. Hopefully, if you don't fail anything.
I'm not. I'm actually doing...
Really well.
I wouldn't say really well. Decent. Above average.
C's get degrees, baby. C's get degrees. Nobody's going to ask you, hey, when you go for a job interview, hey, what grade did you get in this class, you know?
Yeah, that's what you told me like a few months ago.
C's get degrees, baby. That's what I've learned, especially in nursing school, bro. There's these people who, like, you know, at the beginning they tell us, oh, this is going to be the hardest thing you do in your life. You're not going to have a life. You're not going to have any time for your family, blah, 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 bro. I did the bare minimum, and I was out here coaching and chilling, and, you know, and I passed my, you know, the LVN program, like, well, there was people just killing themselves and, you know, trying to get, like, all A's and shit. It's like, we're, you know, we both graduated, and I scraped myself by, you know, and I plan to do the same thing in the RN program, bro.
And you even passed that, what was the test called again?
The NCLEX.
NCLEX, first you
time,
did.
Bro.
You
I
passed
showed
it
up
the
there.
First time.
Bro, I didn't even eat breakfast that day, bro. I didn't even eat breakfast. I just pulled up. I took that joint, passed easily.
You weren't even studying. We were still coaching at that time.
Yeah, bro.
Three times a week.
Yeah.
And we're playing basketball, what, twice a week?
Yeah. And, you know there obviously is a certain level, like, of discipline that you have. Like, you have to do your work, and you have to obviously study a little bit for tests and, like, want to pass. But I'm just not, I don't know, bro. I'm not an overachiever like that, just because I think in reality, when you get out into the real world, nobody cares if you're an overachiever or not. You know, nobody fucking cares. If you're way for yourself and it just makes you feel better, like, go for it, honestly. But I'm not about to kill myself, like, you know, to get like a freaking 4.0 just so I can graduate and get the same job as everybody else who, you know.
And, you know, the pay, they're not getting higher.
Exactly, bro. Exactly.
Everyone's doing the same thing, you know.
Yeah.
Why not just enjoy a little bit?
Yes,
you know, do the things that you like. Do the things that you enjoy.
Yeah. Because at the same time, bro, I would have probably killed myself if I was in here studying, going to school all day, coming home, studying 8 hours, you know. I can't do it, bro. I get home, and if I have a test, like, I'll study the night before, you know, for like a couple hours.
Because if it's that difficult, as they say it is, you're not going to have a life.
Exactly.
You're going to come home. You're going to bury your head in the books.
Yeah.
And what? You go to school for 8 hours a day just to come home and do more? You know, you don't even have time to relax or at least take a walk outside, get some sun,
bro.
You know?
Couldn't be me. Yeah. All right. So I guess we better start wrapping it up now because I know you have to get out of here soon.
I do.
So Kyler Diggins, Coach Khye the Guy, DeMar DeAsian. I appreciate you coming out today, and I'm sure you're going to be like a recurring guest, you know?
I do plan on being a regular guest.
Yeah. Yeah. Because to be honest, I don't know that many people. So.
Me neither.
If it's not you, you know, then I don't know. Yeah, I mean, I have a few lined up. You know.
Are we saying names here?
We can name drop. Yeah, we can name drop, but nobody's going to know who it is besides me.
True.
You know? But yeah, like I said, you know, it's not like a special guest. I mean, I'm sure there'll be people, hopefully, like, I have guests that like I would like to have on to like talk about what they do because they're like unique and they do certain like cool things. But I, honestly, it's just like the point of this podcast is just to like have conversations with like my buddies and like chat about stuff that, you know, kind of like catch up. And well, I said I would talk about the name this time, the Dynamic Wizard, and people are probably like, what the hell is that? You know? So I've already told you this, but just to let everybody else know, I wanted to call it the shit show, right? The slightly helpful and informative talk show, but it was taken. So I started like trying to come up with other things. Everything was taken. Everything was taken. So I didn't want to call it something like my name, like the Matt Mendoza podcast, because I feel like that's kind of corny, you know? So I was like, what can I do? So I thought about Childish Gambino. And for those who don't know, Childish Gambino, Donald Glover, the way he got his name is he plugged it into the Wu-Tang name generator. And it came out with Childish Gambino, which is probably like one of the most fire names you could probably like get out of something like that, you know? So I went to the Wu-Tang name generator and I started putting in different things like Matt Mendoza, Matt's podcast, stuff like that. And I finally put in, but I didn't like anything that it was coming up with. And so I finally put the Matt Mendoza podcast and it came out with the Dynamic Wizard. And I was like, oh my gosh, bro, that's it. That's it. That's the one. Because like I told you, I mean, it's just like a, it's just like a dynamic show, a dynamic podcast, just like talking about whatever we want, you know? And I feel like I'm kind of like a wizard, you know? I feel like I'm kind of like a wizard.
I think you are.
Thank you, bro. I'm a huge Harry Potter
fan. The bedroom too?
Bro, this isn't going on OnlyFans. This is Spotify, so we don't want to get, you know? But that's a different conversation. Coach Khye, thank you for being on the show today.
Well, thank you for having me. It's been a pleasure. My first time doing a podcast.
You did absolutely amazing. You're very well-spoken. You enunciate. And that's, surprising as English is what? Your fourth language or something like that?
Oh, I don't even know. I want to say second or third. It has to be. Yeah, because wow. I know a few other more languages that we speak back home.
Yeah, and we'll get more in depth on that in a different episode. But yeah, that was the official first episode of the Dynamic Wizard podcast.
Episode one,
baby. Yes, sir.
It's about to be released tomorrow.
Yeah, and it's crazy to think by next year, you know.
We're going to have, what?
We're going to have thousands, millions of people even listening.
Hopefully. Yeah. If this blows up, we don't have to work for the rest of our lives. So it's up to them if they want to watch it or not, you know. Yeah.
So please don't, you know, if we have to start showing feet on here to get more views, we'll do it, baby.
It's just him.
Yeah.
I'm not showing any feet here.
We got to start showing nut sacks.
Nope.
Yes, sir. We'll do whatever it takes, baby. Let us know. Let us know what you want to see.
I'll do professional basketball coaching.
Okay. All right. Well, that's it for today. So we'll see you guys next Friday.
See you guys.
Coach Khye, we're signing off.
Coach Matt, we're signing off.
Thank you. He's been knocking and you still haven't opened a door. Trying to get the new Givenchy briefs because I like the couture. So many problems in this world that I'd rather ignore. Should be in the trenches right now trying to help out the poor. But